big hello from Australia. How keen are you to get back down here?
I can't tell you. 8 years, I think, in waiting. And Australia is one of those countries where the spirit comes with you wherever you go. So whenever I think of Australia, I just think of how warm the people are and the indomitable spirit of the Australian people. I'm from a working class city in America, Chicago. And Australian culture, by and large, reminds me of Chicago. There's a certain toughness and a sweetness. It's a weird combination, but you have to be around it to know it. And that's so to me, it's, I don't want to say it feels like home, but it reminds me of home.
Well, we're so excited to have you and your music back here. As a band, I feel that the Smashing Pumpkins is really one that pushes the envelope. So how do you balance that need to be creative musically with the need for commercial success so that you can afford to be creative?
That's a great question. I think it's, for me, it's, I always go back to a band like the Beatles or the Stones, and I know I'm dating myself, but it's that perfect moment, like a song like Satisfaction or Day Tripper or something like that, where the commercial part comes together with the artistic. Those are always the best moments in culture. Because what it really does is it sends a message that you can be super creative, and if you do it at a high level, the whole world will celebrate you for your audaciousness. But you have to embrace it. You kind of can't half be a weirdo. You either are or you aren't. I've always been a weirdo. And I've had millions of people in boardrooms pull me aside and say, you know, if you just tone it down and stop being so weird, you know, things would go better for you. But they don't understand. It's like, I wasn't made in a test tube, you know? I'm the result of two crazy families and a strange upbringing, and obviously America is a very strange country, but that's where sort of bringing to get everybody together under a concert is the most egalitarian thing you can do, because you're really celebrating the human spirit. And that's what I always loved the band, like about a band like Midnight Oil, I got to see back in the day, as they really represented the true, you know, spirit of all of Australia, not just one part of it. And that's always something I really respected about them.
This is huge. You're an Oils fan. This is a massive scoop. This is big for Aussies.
Oh yeah. One of the greatest bands I've ever seen. I saw them play a club in Chicago twice called The Metro.
Wow.
And some of the best concerts I've ever seen. What a great band.
They're so incredible. Do you think that we could see some of those Peter Garrett moves on stage for you when you're down here on the tour?
This is why I do not dance, because I often made this joke at weddings, which is people are like, why don't you dance at the wedding? And I said, because I look like Peter Garrett on a bender, you know what I mean?
That could be a more streamlined Peter Garrett. We don't know. You could come down here and do it. We might see.
I'm a little bit more fluid than Peter. I don't know him, so I feel weird calling him Peter, but I'm a little bit more fluid. I'm a little bit more loosey-goosey. He's kind of got the, you know, the robot man of the future thing he does, but he does it well.
As a band with dance moves and music that's always bucked the norm, it's no surprise their latest drop is the three-part album, Autumn, full to the brim with rock opera tracks.
Everybody told me it was a crazy idea, and but as I like to say, look, I had a crazy idea with Melancholy, and it went on to be the biggest album we ever did, and certainly one of the biggest albums of all time. So once you do something completely insane, it's hard to go back. Well, everybody told me outside the band that it was the worst idea I could imagine. No one's going to listen to it and all this stuff that people try to scare you away. And that just made me want it all the more. And then you have old school Smashing Pumpkins fans who are screaming 29 years later that it doesn't sound like Siamese Dream. And it's like, as I always like to remind them, you have Siamese Dream if you want to listen to it again. Like, I don't understand. Like, nothing is erased, right?
Well, yeah, it does make sense when you put it like that. So is there this frustration, I guess, around the politics that comes with old school Pumpkin fans?
It's not frustrating, but to give you a poor example, it would be if I held up a photo of you from, say, 15 years ago, and I'd say, see how you look here? You're never going to look better. It's like a weird thing to say to somebody. Like, first of all, how do you judge that? And secondarily, how do you know that's true? Now, if we're talking about music, how can you say for sure that I will never create a better album than pick your album?
Well, with all of that, though, you do seem, I think, you seem to be in a really great place, a right place. Is that correct?
It's either a great act or I actually am really in a good place. I'll let you judge that.
Well, pair that acting with some Peter Garrett moves and you've got a show. Billy Corgan, thank you so much for your time. We'll see you soon.
We'll pull a Midnight Oil cover out just for you.
Yes, beds are burning.
Okay, take care, bye.
It's a brilliant album.
Yes, and he does. He's in a great place, but he is sitting there, it looks like, protecting himself against a break-in. Yeah. So I don't know what...
He was up against the door. It looked like he was ready to roll at any moment.
Yeah, it was extraordinary. But the third instalment of the Smashing Pumpkins' new album, Autumn, is out on May the 5th. You can head to our website for more information on their huge Aussie tour, which kicks off in April.